Hello, I'm Morgan Berry at WFO Mobile Pensacola. As a part of this series on social media data mining, I'm going to cover Waze, searching for live information. Now, instead of diving right into mining for reports on Waze, I want to explain a little bit about Waze, since it is not as well known as other social media platforms that we are used to, such as Facebook and Twitter. Waze is very useful during high-impact weather events, and these tips will also likely help you on your commute home. Waze is a free, community-driven GPS navigation app for iPhones and Android phones. Waze users are known as Wazers, and they can report accidents, traffic jams, police, and most importantly to us, other road hazards such as trees down or roads closed due to high water. This app uses that crowdsourced information to help other Wazers and drivers. Waze also relies on information from state agencies for big events like construction sites or, more importantly, hurricane shelters or evacuation routes. Now, the Waze Live Map is a browser-based version of the Waze Maps that you would see on the app. It displays current traffic and reports from Wazers using their app. So let's go ahead and dive into data mining on the Waze Live Map. You can access this map by heading to waze.com/livemap, and this is what it looks like. Now, from here, you should zoom into the area with hazardous weather. Now, one thing to keep in mind is if you do have a slow internet connection, it may take a little bit of time to zoom into the area of concern. Now, I know that there is ongoing weather in the northeast as of the time of this recording, so I'm going to zoom into the Boston area. Now, while you zoom in to an area with weather, you may notice a plethora of different symbols. The further I zoom in, the more colors and the more symbols that we see. So as soon as I can get some symbols to pop up, there we go, I will explain what these are. The barricade symbols will be very helpful to you. These display road closures. The police symbols, like this one over here, that just means that there is a police in the area that has been spotted by a Wazer. The warning or danger symbol, like this one up here, or several of these down here, these mean that there is a road-related hazard. This is very helpful to us because that could be weather-related, so we could be looking at a tree down or perhaps some flooding in the area. It could also not be weather-related. It could be a pothole or perhaps an animal in the road. There are other symbols, which I do not see on this map. You may see one with cars colliding. That just means that there is a car crash. And different colors with numerous cars on them, like this red one up here, that means that there's a traffic jam. Now, one tip is to make sure that you zoom in far enough to get those extra details. If I click on this barricade right here, you notice that all it tells me is the road is closed and it's due to flooding. So if you do not zoom in far enough, you will see very little detail about the icon. Now, if we continue to zoom in, you notice more and more icons do pop up. I'm going to zoom as far as it lets me. And now when I click on it for further details, I can get the name of the road or intersection that is closed. I could potentially get pictures or other updates from other users as well. So when you zoom in and click on that icon, you're able to also see how many thumbs up votes it has received from local Wazers, meaning that they too saw the same report. It may also contain additional comments, which you would see right here, or pictures from local Wazers. And it also gives you the time that the report was received by Waze right here. Now, this doesn't necessarily mean that that is when the report occurred. That doesn't mean that the flooding occurred right that second or the tree fell right then. That's just when the person or the Wazer saw the event. Now, something to keep in mind is that sometimes Wazers don't include that much information in their report. But you can always use other social media platforms such as Twitter and Facebook to search for more information on that report using what you do know. So in this particular example, the street name, the area or the town, or the type of report. The road colors that you see on this map, let me zoom out just a little bit here. These also are very similar to what you would see in Google Maps. So if you were to click on the red or yellow colors, you can get more information about the traffic or about that particular road. Now, something to keep in mind, if you're searching for reports related to perhaps severe storms or a tornado, those road colors could actually mean something, or those road closures. It may mean that that hazardous weather rolled through that area and traffic is not able to get through. So that's something to keep in mind. Also, something to keep in mind is that the more you zoom in or zoom out, the more the map gets updated and the reports come in frequently. So it may change. You may be looking at the map and icons may randomly move on you. Now, depending on the time of day or the event, there may be many Wazers on this map. The Wazers are denoted by the friendly, bubbly looking vehicles with wheels, like this one right here, with some sort of funny expression. If you try to click on one of these Wazers, like I'm doing right now, nothing happens. You cannot gather details about these Wazers or the drivers on the web interface. Now, that being said, if you have a personal account on your personal phone, you can actually view the details about the Wazers. And the one that I just clicked on is all of a sudden gone. So you notice, as I mentioned, that these reports do update quite frequently. Now, another good idea is to search for the term Waze using the Twitter search feature. So I've already done that here in the top right corner in the search bar on Twitter. I typed in Waze and then clicked on people. This allows you to locate the regional Wazer accounts and the bigger city accounts. These Twitter accounts are managed by map editors, and the accounts sometimes post unusual reports that they run across in their area, such as road closures due to weather. So it's always a good idea if you're data mining for reports to look here and see if any of the bigger accounts are in the area of concern for you. Now, another great account to look at is Waze_USA. And this account is great to check during an event. During bigger events, they are posting quite frequently. And they also post when they activate their virtual EOC, which is comprised of volunteers who work 24/7 to keep that map updated. Now, if I scroll down their timeline here, they don't really have any events listed, or their EOC is not listed. They do keep up to date with a lot of weather information. So since it looks like their VOC has not been activated, I'm going to show you an example from the past. This example is from Hurricane Irma, when they did activate their virtual EOC. Since this event is over, you cannot see any other reports, but in real time, you would be able to see updated shelter information, closed roads, weather-related hazards, etc. Those Waze volunteers search for reports on Twitter to add to the maps, in addition to all of those reports that they are receiving from drivers and Wazers in the area, in addition to those state entities that help them out. Now, to see ongoing events that may not trigger their virtual EOC, there's another live map that you can head to, and that is waze.com/events. I know that there is ongoing weather as we speak across Southern California, so I will zoom into this particular area and see if I can get one of these events to pop up. And there we go. So if I click on this one called Southern California Storm that's happening right now, I can get more information. So it zooms me into the area of concern. It shows me roads that are closed, and I can actually open the closure list. And it explains which roads are closed due to that particular weather event. So this could be handy in real time to search for weather-related road closures. So that's all that I have for data mining using Waze. So I hope that you check out our other data mining lessons in this series. Thanks!